Hello and welcome to day 11 of the Halloween Craft Countdown, where I'm releasing a new Cricut tutorial every day for the whole of October. Today's tutorial is gonna get your taste buds going because we're making stencils for fondant icing. So this is a really fun way to add some interest to your Halloween cookies. You'll cut these designs out of acetate on your Cricut machine and then use a rolling pin to emboss the designs into fondant icing, which can then decorate your cookies, or you could use it for cupcakes or any other type of baking where you cover it in icing. Let's see how it works. When you load the free SVG file into Design Space, it will look like this. So all four of the cookie stencil designs are grouped together. This means you can click and drag to resize them and they'll all change at the same rate. If you want to change them to a specific size, so maybe to match your stencils, then you'll need to ungroup them first. So click on the layer in the Layers panel, right click and then press Ungroup. Alternatively, if I just undo that, once you've clicked them in the Layers panel, you can press the Ungroup button, which is just above it. Now that these are all separate, you can click on each one and then resize it by typing into the size box. So for my cookies, I've done them all at 3.5 inches. So once you've resized them all, then you can go ahead and make it. So you want to cut these out of acetate, and that is one of the types you can cut with your maker. So search for acetate and then choose that. Make sure you use quite a thick acetate because you need to be able to get a good roll on the icing to emboss the patterns. If your acetate is really, really thin, like some acetate you get is kind of the same weight as the protective covers that come on the Cricut mats, that's too thin to use really. You won't get a good effect when you roll over the stencils onto the icing. You want acetate that is a bit thicker. The acetate that I used says that it is 220 mic or mic, not sure how you pronounce it, but that seemed to be a good thickness that gave me a really nice effect when I rolled over it onto the icing. So go ahead and cut things out. Don't worry when you're cutting out of acetate that it cuts each bit twice. It is a double cut, so your Cricut would do each little shape twice. So it does take a little while to cut. It took about 10 to 12 minutes to cut all four out from my acetate. But once you have cut them out, go ahead and bake your lovely, lovely cookies following any recipe you want, or for my recipe, check the link in my blog. So once you've got the stencils and your cookies, it's time to get your decoration on. The first thing you'll need to do is to download the free cookie stencil templates from my blog. I'll put a link to the page in the description of this video, and then go ahead and cut them out from acetate. So it's going to be quite hard to show you these because obviously they're see-through. But I cut these out so that they are a little bit bigger than my cookie cutter shapes. So the reason I do it a bit bigger is that when you cut it with the cookie cutter, it means you've got the pattern all the way up to the edge. I've already made my biscuits, so here they are. I've got some ghosts and some pumpkins and then just some plain circles as well. So these are just kind of normal sugar cookies, but I put in a spoonful of cinnamon and a spoonful of mixed spices to give them a bit of an autumnal Halloween-y taste to them. Alright, so my biscuits are cooked, they are all completely cool, which means it's ready to ice them. So I have already prepared some orange icing for my pumpkin one, so I've just wrapped that up in cling film to stop it drying out. And that's why I have all these blotchy yellow bits on my hands, it's the dye from the food colouring. But I've also got some white icing left over, which I'm going to put on the ghosts and on the circles. I've got some kind of sparkle dust, edible sparkly dust, which I'm going to put on the ones that I do on the circles as well, just to give them a bit of extra shimmer. And then I've got a brand new paintbrush, which I will use to apply that shimmer a little bit later. Okay, so to start with, I'm going to do the white ones, because I don't want any of my orange dye getting on the white icing. Although I guess it might come off my hands. I should have coloured it after doing the white ones, but never mind. I'm going to take some of my white fondant icing And this is just ready to roll fondant icing. I'm just going to move it about with my hands for a little bit to get it a bit more pliable and easy to roll. Okay, let's move my cookies out the way. I'm a little bit cramped in here. There's not a lot of room for baking. So I'm kind of just trying to move everything out the way. When your icing is a little bit more pliable, so you can see this is now moving a lot easier, it's time to roll it out. So get a little bit of icing sugar and just put it over your work surface to try and stop your icing from sticking. My icing sugar's clumped a bit, I probably should have sieved it, but then it would have gone everywhere. So it's just have that there, and then take my icing. And I've got a rolling pin and I'm going to roll this out. I've got a bit of yellow colouring on it already. Oops. Oh there, that's where I rolled it in my hands, I'm sure. Never mind. These things are sent to try us. Okay, so you want to roll out your icing so that it's a little bit thicker than the thickness you actually want to go on the cookie. So I tend to like my icing fairly thin so it's not too overpowering. So this is probably about just over a quarter of an inch thick at the minute. And I do want it thinner, but when it's this thickness, it's time to add the stencils. So I'm going to start with a ghost one. I choose the stencil you want to use. I think I'll go for the spider web. And then just put the stencil on top of your icing. And then take the rolling pin. I'm running out of room. And then roll over the stencil with the rolling pin. So do it all in one smooth motion and press quite firmly. So this will be the roll that gets the icing to the thickness you want to go on top of the cookie. And it's also going to emboss the spiderweb design into the icing. So I'm just going to go ahead and push that in. And then I can pick the template out of the icing. And you can see you're left with this perfect spiderweb pattern. So now I can take my ghost cutter and cut the icing around that design. And then that will be ready to add onto my cookie. So actually I have still done that quite thick. I probably should have done it thinner. I'm going to start again. I'm not a natural baker, I just really wanted to try the stencils. Alright, so let's roll this out again and try take two. Alright, so this time I've rolled my icing out much thinner, so let's give it another go. Here is my spider web. And then I'm just going to roll over it. Press nice and firmly. And there's the nice pretty design. Hopefully you can see it on the camera. I'm not sure, there's quite a lot of light spill on it, so you might not be able to. But now I can cut out the ghost. That's a much better thickness. My cookie cutters aren't very good because they're leaving a little edge around the shape. I'm just going to take that off with my nail. I've just moved that ghost to one side so I can work on some of the other designs. So I've got the one with the ghost and the bats. I'll move that up to the top and then, oh gosh, this is so limited room in here. Let's move my icing over a bit. Just knocked my microphone over. Clever move. Right. Okay, so I can roll down over that. And that's pressed all those little ghosts and bats into the icing. And now I'll cut it out with my very, very posh circular cookie cutter, aka a wine glass. And get that. And then that is another one ready. So I'm just going to go through and cut some more ghost and circular shapes out of my white icing. And then I'll show you how to stick it onto the cookies. Once you've got your icing cut out and all nicely stenciled, it's time to add it onto your cookies. Now you could use some icing sugar mixed with a little bit of water to add icing on here, but I find it works just fine just with a little bit of water. So I'm just going to put my finger in the water, put a little bit on the cookie, and then the icing will just stick to it. Push it down gently, making sure you don't push too hard, otherwise you'll take out the stencil pattern. And then when that dries, it'll be all nicely stuck. Let's do the same on this one. Be nice and quick so that it's still wet when you put the icing on, or you could actually put the water on the back of the icing. That'd probably be smarter. And then a little ghost, so let's try it that way. Put the water on the icing. Make it all sticky. And then put it onto the cookie. Here we are. I think that worked better. It was just a little bit more fiddly. So as you can see, this is a really fun way to decorate your cookies and give them a bit of extra pizzazz when you're icing them. So this cookie's got this lovely ghosty icing, but also it has the spiderweb pattern on it. If I tilt it, you can see. And then these cookies, they've got the little patterns on them as well. But for these white ones, I'm going to enhance the little emboss effect even more with my glitter. So this is like a little purple sparkly dust, which is edible. I'm just going to take a tiny bit on a paintbrush and just gently brush around the icing. And not only does this add a lovely shine, but it makes the pattern really pop out so you can see it even more. Here's my sparkly cookie, and it does show up the pattern much better. I'll take some photos and show you the photos. That'll probably work better. But now I just need to go through and decorate all the rest of my cookies. So I've got the rest of my white icing to use, and also the orange icing, which I'm going to put on the pumpkins. So I'll go ahead and do that and then show you how it all looks. So here are my decorator cookies, and I took a photo of them rather than do it on video, just so that I know that you can see all the pretty stenciling effects. So this was fun to do, if a little bit fiddly, but I think it was definitely worth it, as these cookies now have that extra wow factor. So if you want the recipe for the cookies or the SVG for the stencils, check out the link in the description of this video. If you enjoyed my rather messy attempts at doing some baking, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I promise that the rest of it is not baking related. It's all just wonderful Cricut crafts. And I'm releasing a new Cricut craft every day for October. And don't worry, I'm not going to try baking again. Actually, maybe once. Maybe one more, but it won't be cookies. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this. Please leave me a comment if you have any cookie tips that you think I need, because clearly I need help. Let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. Bye.